talked to God a lot about you over the years. He said he broke the mold when he made you. He said he's sure entertaining to watch, but lead you too much trouble.
Now, Tony, this is set in the 1930s in the Depression era of the Ozarks.
Yeah.
We have Robert Duvall playing a character based on a real character, a hermit, kind of a tonic center, who's kind of reviled by the
Roof. Roof.
Awake, and he wants to attend it and sort of tell stories. And he's in a raffle. Yes, he's in a raffle on his property, and Bill Murray is kind of the huckster funeral director. He's moved to this small town from Chicago, kind of a sharpie, but things aren't going well for him, so he takes this on as a business proposition because he sees a big payday in this funeral.
Yeah, I love this
one. I like it. I think that this is a kind of eccentricity of the characters that really works. I think Duvall is fantastic. Really takes you inside this tormented, but also very sly and funny and charming man. The charm opens up slowly.
Slowly.
I had a few problems with this story. I felt that the end, the big revelation of the secret in the man's past was a little unconvincing.
A little plotty was conventional, but I think the feeling is absolutely enormous in it. And I think the
performance of Sissy Spacek
and the precision of all these performers was really excellent.
Coming up next,
we love Snow Napalm in the Morning, or at least the man who uttered that line. We look back at the remarkable career of Robert Duvall.
But first, only two more episodes of Happy Movies remain, so let's take a look back at a classic moment from the show. Here, demonstrating that they were never afraid to take on Hollywood heavyweights, Rob Hubert and Gene Siskel review Bill Cosby's Leonard Part 6.
Frankie, hey, baby. Hey. Hey, look. Look, Frankie. Frankie. Hey. Hey, Frankie. Frankie.
His 20-year-old daughter brings home a 66-year-old man that she wants to marry. Cosby is appalled. This guy is robbing the cradle.
Hey.
What does he do? He calls
Frankie.
For a sandwich and a Coke. And then he holds the Coke bottle prominently.
Knock it off.
The rest of the scene. First it says Coca-Cola, then the next shot.
Frankie.
Coke, in case you missed the point. We released this movie, Columbia. Who owns Columbia? Coca-Cola. What is Coca-Cola doing with this movie? They have a lot of products in this movie, Gene.
Hey. Hey. You're okay, Frankie. Hey. What you doing, little boy? Hey. What you doing? Hey, Frankie. Frankers.